And then first now, maybe, you know, we have talked about Islamic finance before, you know, application. Let us, you know, going back a little bit to the philosophy. We can go to the next slide, maybe. Okay, first, you know, I mentioned before that the vision of the Sharia economy, I mean, Islamic banking, basically the product of this, you know, Islamic economy, okay? And then in the Islamic economy, we talk about the maqasid of Sharia, the objective of the Sharia, okay? This is the central theme of the economic development from the perspective of the Sharia. And then, of course, you know, Islamic banking, since they are the product of the Islamic finance and Islamic economy, they cannot separate, you know, itself from the objective of this Sharia. And then what is the objective of the Sharia? And then, you know, we can go to the next slide. I think this, you know, I quoted two great Muslim thinkers, okay, who try to catch, you know, the objective of the Sharia. The first one from this Al-Ghazali, okay. So we can see here together, I mean, the very objective of the Sharia is to promote the welfare of the people, okay, which lies in safeguarding their faith, their life, their intellect, their posterity, and their wealth. Okay, posterity is like turunan. Life, and then, you know, intellect, kita punya intellect, and their wealth, and mal, kekayaan kita. Whatever ensure the safeguarding of these five serve public interest and is desirable. So this is basically the objective of the Sharia. And then the second one, this is from Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim, okay. The basis of the Sharia is the wisdom and the welfare of the people, okay, in this world as well as the hereafter. So we have this, you know, integrated paradigm, okay. When we talk about welfare, we don't talk about just the welfare in this world, okay. But I mean, you know, this is also, we care about the welfare of the people in the hereafter. Because you see, like, you succeed in this world, but the way you succeed, I mean, you do a lot of harm. You are harming people. And then you will not succeed in the hereafter. Because you will be accountable for what you have done. So this will be like, you know, check and balance, okay, from what you are doing. I mean, don't just see, like, you know, the success of the people, for example, you know, don't just be happy with the success here, because we need to ensure how can we be successful also in the hereafter. So then this is integrated paradigm, okay. I mean, even, okay, in the West, okay, people start thinking like, you know, this kind of thing. You know, there was like, you know, the work of the philosopher Immanuel Kant, okay, from German. It was very interesting, okay. He said that the life of this world is not complete. Okay, then, you know, there will be the other half of the world where the justice will be carried out. Because you know why he said this? Because he said some people who are wrong, okay, who are oppressed, sometimes they have never had chance to take the revenge in this world. Okay, and then those who have done wrong, who have oppressed others, I mean, they are never, you know, they are never accountable to this, okay? They can escape justice. So then he said, you know, that's why there has to be the other half of the world where the justice will be carried out, so the even one. Okay, and then let us move, okay? I mean, this concept, this, the previous slide, please. Okay, and then this welfare lies in complete justice, mercy, well-being, and wisdom. Anything that depart from justice to oppression, from mercy to harshness, from welfare to misery, and from wisdom to folly has nothing to do with the Sharia. So this is very important, okay, for us to understand the concept. Because in Indonesia, sometimes, you know, due to our lack of understanding, okay, maybe your older generation, you know, so sometimes, you know, people have like, you know, what they call it, Sharia phobia, okay, about what is this, okay. People talk, when talking about Sharia, people think about just the hudud, the criminal, you know, law of Islam, cutting off the hand, you know, something like that. So they don't really, you know, go further. So this is very important, I mean, yeah. So we don't want later, you know, people from the West teach us about the Sharia, okay. I mean, then we are here, I mean, you know, we don't really grasp it. Okay, let's go to the next slide. Okay, I mentioned before, okay. So then because of this objective, okay. So bank Syariah, then it has to have, vision. Actually, now I'm talking like, I was a player, okay, for a long time in the Islamic banking industry. So then, I saw it from inside. So then, I want to share, for example, we need to make of, like the Syariah bank. I think they need to have objective bigger than just making the profit. Okay. Of course, profit is important. Without profit, it might not be sustainable. But then, it should not be just the only objective. Okay. I mean, the objective should be bigger than that. I will show you later, okay, that this is not something new, actually. Okay. Even in the Western world. So, okay, we can move to the next slide. Okay, there is one interesting book. Okay, if you study about, there is a book called Good to Great and Build to Last. Okay, the book study about the most enduring companies in the United States. Okay, so many of these companies actually, they started. They don't just think about profit. Okay, they think something bigger. For example, let me quote one medicine company, Merck. So you know what they have objective? For example, to save life. Okay, to save life. So to save life, it means they have to create very good medicine, good quality medicine. So when they create good quality medicine, and then people buy that one, and then the profit comes on its own. Okay. So this is something that I mean with the bigger objective. Or like, HP, for example, Hewlett Packard, you might be familiar with this. Their vision, for example, creating something that contributes to the welfare of humanity. So this is something bigger, okay? I mean, bigger objective. Or like Ritz-Carlton Hotel, the major, five-star hotel. I mean, how to treat, your customer like feeling at home, they are to be treated very well, something like that. So this bigger objective is very important, okay? Think bigger. So the Islamic Bank, for example, need to think bigger also, like, to provide, like the benefit, the financial benefit of the people, okay? So then later we will talk, for example, the quality service here will be important, product innovation, okay? And then, other aspects, okay, that might not be, dealt with today. So then this is, to show that this is something new to have something bigger objective, especially for us, okay, for the Islamic finance, Islamic banking. So because the value should be like, the primary, the driving force, okay, the values, the vision, something like that. Okay, next. Of course, this kind of thing is not easy because sometimes, we live in the world where everything is seen like, short-term. We have sometimes, short-term orientation, okay, in life. But it is not impossible. I mean, it is very possible, as we have seen, there is a case of that. Okay. So this is the orientation later, how this creation of the Islamic banking, okay, who think bigger objective, okay, so that who care about like this issue of the ethical finance, sustainable development, something like that, okay, then can contribute also to the enhancement of this, Islamic banking later on. Okay, next. Okay, let's ask now, although before Danny has shown, about the state of this our Islamic banking. Let us just move briefly again, okay? Actually, number-wise, before 2014, okay, what we have achieved is not bad, okay? I mean, the growth of Indonesian Islamic banking sector was quite fast, right? I mean, it grew like, double than the conventional banking sector. So, our share is still small, less than 5% Islamic banking. But then the graph, okay, it was fast, okay, before. Oh, Of course, there was slowdown in 2013 and then in 2014. But then we will see, you know, why there was slowdown. The way I see it, this is, the time, to improve also, the quality of the asset of the Islamic banks, internally. Because at the end, Islamic bank doesn't mean like, it is run by the holy people. Okay? There are good people also, bad people, something like that. It is important to have good governance, good governance, in running the bank, including the Islamic bank. Okay? So when you don't have good governance, you don't have good people, people with good character to run the bank, it could create also problem, like this quality asset issue. It could be like, this financing assessment quality is compromised there, So this is something like, that we can learn, from the slowdown of the Islamic banking in 2014. Okay, we can go next slide, this is the one that I told you before, how, the Islamic banks, the graph, more than the industry between 2008 to 2012. Okay, but this is something that we can, we can capitalize on. Ini apa model dasar? Next please. What is the impact of the growth of the Islamic banking? And then it created opening of the employment, of course. Human resources. The need of the office staff. So it has. This is the area where the Islamic banking contributes somehow. It has the development impact. Because this opening, the employment for the people. Next. So this is some important aspect also that we need to look at. About the financing component by contracts, and then the financing segments, and then financial usage, and then I will mention briefly, something raised by Padani about the composition of the funding, between how the time deposits still dominate the Islamic banking. So the financing segment composition by contracts, you know, in Islamic banking you have debt financing and equity financing, basically, So the equity financing, it is called mudarabah or musyarakah. This is equity financing. And then you have debt financing. Debt financing basically like the murabaha, and then istisna, salam, ijarah, it is also part of the debt financing. Debt financing basically like the fixed income, Some people, sometimes they complain. When I was the director of Bank Muamalat, sometimes I get complained when I met with the business people. Why it is the same, they say. Why it is the same? Because, some Islamic bank, the main financing segment of the bank is the murabaha. Murabaha is debt financing. So it, somehow it looks the same. Although it is actually different, because there is akad there. Akad is making the difference, and then when you pay early, you don't get penalty, something like that. But from outside, it is it seems it is the same.